G'day everyone, welcome to the video and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to talk about and demonstrate how to remove the gear knob from your VE SS Commodore, and also the video covers how to replace the gear boot, the leather gear boot, in your VE SS Commodore. I think the same process can also be applied to just a standard manual V6 Commodore, if that's what you've got. So here we go. You just saw the new gear boot that I bought off an online store. There's my existing gear boot, which is worn around where it joins onto the gear knob. This car has done about 80,000 kilometers, and it's just a little bit worn. So to get to the removing the gear knob, you've got to remove this center console panel. You start at the back there and just with a screwdriver lever up the back of that panel. It's just held in by clips, so once you've levered the back up, you can just use your finger pulling up slightly, working your way from the back of it to the front. Just go along one side with your finger underneath lifting it up, and then along the other side, and you'll then be able to lift the whole thing up. Now at this stage you won't be able to remove that from your car because you've got a few plugs underneath that are still connected. In this next section of the video, I'm unscrewing the gear boot from the console with that piece still in place. As you can see there, you are far better off reaching underneath and undoing the wiring clips to the switches in that center console piece and lifting it up and removing it entirely. Anyway, there's four screws you want to undo here once that piece is removed. Those four screws hold the boot down to the console. And once you've removed those four screws and that center piece, you've got that out of the way, you then need to work on removing the gear knob. Now, a lot of you have probably come to this video to work out how to remove that gear knob. You do not screw that gear knob off like you would in an old school manual car. That gear knob is pressed on, which means you've got to pull it up to get it off. So here's a few tips that I've worked out over time. Do not pull that gear knob up with your face over the top, or it will suddenly come off and smack you straight in the face. And I've heard of people doing that. You need to grip it tight and rotate it side to side as much as you can, which won't be much, and lift and pull it up at the same time, and it will pop off. And that is how you remove that gear knob. Once you've got the gear knob off and you want to replace the gear boot, as I'm doing here, move out of your car onto a workbench, and just basically what you need to first do is get that plastic plate off the bottom. So you've got to, and that just pulls out. That gear boot is only just pressed into there. There's no screws, no clips. It's literally just forced in and pinched into that plastic piece. You just pull it out as I'm doing there. Work your way around it, and you'll eventually separate the leather gear boot from the plastic retaining clip. Put that plastic retaining clip over to the side, and now just work with your gear knob and gear boot. That is held together by it's held together by a zip tie from the factory. You need to cut that zip tie, and that will allow you to remove the leather boot from the gear knob. Once you've got that cut, just peel it away and pull the zip tie off. And now you'll be able to separate the gear knob from the gear boot. Just while you're removing that zip tie, just make a note of how it goes on, because now what you're going to do is reattach your gear knob to your new gear boot, and it's going to be done in the same way. So push the gear knob through the top of the new gear boot and then turn the whole thing inside out. So essentially what you'll have is the gear knob up inside the gear boot and the whole thing turned inside out, and that now is where you need to put your new zip tie to hold the two together. Depending on the gear boot that you've purchased, you might have a little bit of trouble, as I did here, but just keep working with that so that you've got the new gear boot in the right position on the gear knob, and that's when you're then going to put a zip tie around there and zip it up nice and tight. There is a groove there where the zip tie locks into, which I just pointed out a moment ago with the screwdriver. And once you've done that up nice and tight, turn it back the right way around and make sure you line up your gear knob with the stitching, if it's got some prominent stitching like this one has. A red car, so red stitching in the gear boot. I thought it was a pretty good match. So I've adjusted that now the way I would like it. And it's time to fit this back into the retainer, the plastic retainer. And it's just a reversal of the removal process. You basically need to, with a blunt instrument, you need to push the leather gear boot down into the groove of the plastic retaining clip. As you push it down into that groove, the way it's designed, it will pinch the leather and hold it. So it's really just working your way around. As I said, with a blunt tool, that screwdriver is actually pretty blunt. It's worn out. It was good for this to get right down into the groove so that the leather boot locked in there and it didn't scratch or damage the leather in any way. That's the finished product. That's the new gear boot with gear knob, and that is, as it sits, ready to go back into the car. Putting this back in is a reversal of the removal process, including reattaching that gear knob. Situate it on top, make sure everything's clear, and screw down the gear boot. You'll see what I was leading up to in a moment. Four screws go back in, so you're holding the retaining ring. You're reattaching that to your center console. Once you put the four screws back in, you'll need to apply this special technique to reattach your gear knob. Remember, it doesn't screw on. When you removed it, you pulled it straight off. So there is a special technique for reattaching it. That's the last screw going in there now. And then you'll see what I'm talking about. Bang, that's it. A couple of extra hits just to make sure, but it did only take one. And that's reattached. So now we put the center, let's call it the switch panel. We put that back in. The first thing to do, once you've just sat it over the top, get those electrical clips back in. They can be a little tricky. Once those electrical clips are back in, you're essentially just pushing that switch panel back down, clipping it back into place, just like that. Very, very, very easy. And that is the finished product. Now, how much better does that look than the worn-out original one? Little bit of custom there with the stitching. It's a much nicer leather with a coarser grain, obviously no wear, and that's all there is to it. If you like the video, please hit the like button, and thanks for watching.